So the deadlift's a great movement because it's a very simple movement to do. It's easy to learn. It trains a lot of muscles in one go. So if you're someone like the vast majority of people who haven't got long in the gym, and you're looking for an exercise that gives you the most bang for your buck, it's going to be the deadlift, because you're training, you know, your quads, hamstrings, calves, your glutes, your core muscles, back, you know, shoulders, everything, you know, traps. It's going to be trained all the way up your body, even your grip if you're not using straps, etc. So it gives you probably the biggest bang for your buck out of any lift out there. And if you've got limited time and you're looking to train and you want to get some intensity into your training, then the deadlift, you know, is a fantastic option. One of those movements that is easily transferable to life. You know, we're picking a dead weight off the floor, and it's something that we have to do a lot in life. You know, whether you've had to pick up bags of sand, or if you're doing some landscaping in the garden, or you've got to shovel mud out of your garden, or whatever, you know, carry the shopping. It's all various movements that are very transferable to life. So it's a great movement, in my opinion, easy to learn, and doesn't take too much for people to implement in their program. The best thing about strength training is that it's all individualistic. It's all about you versus you and getting better and being the strongest you can be. So I think it's a really great way of for young people to train and not focus on what they're seeing in the mirror per se. Obviously, you know, everyone wants to stay healthy and stay in shape, but just focus on improving your lifts or fitness, you know, whatever modality you're using. The great thing about weight training is it's completely measurable. You know, you go in 1 week and you squat 100 kilos, and the next week you manage to squat 105 kilos, and you've shown improvement straight away. Whereas sometimes when you're looking in the mirror, it takes a little while to see those improvements. So my biggest advice would be, you know, focus on the training, focus on the lifting, see those improvements week to week, and the improvements, if you are focused on aesthetics, will come from the training itself. Whatever your goal, you kind of need to see progress, otherwise that's why people fail on their diets, because, you know, their goal is either unrealistic or they want to see fast results. You know, if you're training and you're looking to improve, you either want to be doing more reps on a weight that you've done a few reps before, or you want to be doing more weight for the same reps. Or even another way of progressing is to lift a bar quicker or with better form than you did before with the same weight. I think that's another way of progressing. That's why filming sets is so important. Seeing your progress obviously motivates you in the gym. It ensures that your program is working, and it ensures that you don't kind of get disillusioned with the process, and you can kind of really focus. But take those little wins, half a kilo on a bar, a kilo on the bar, and, you know, one extra rep, lifting a deadlift better than you did the week before with the same weight. They're all little wins, little victories that show you're improving.